This video is for you. Hi everyone! Pera Pera Japanese のゆかです。I was asked, what should I start first for learning Japanese? Or is Japanese difficult? Or I don't know where to start. So in this video, I can answer all these questions. If you already study Japanese, please watch my other video too. Okay then, let's start! First, is Japanese difficult? I think we can say depends on categories. I think pronunciation is very easy compared to most of languages. And speaking, it depends on your goal. If you want to have just small conversation, it's gonna be not so difficult. But if you want to be fluent, it's quite hard because it depends on the situation. We write or speak differently because we have a hanashi kotoba, which is for talking, and we have a kaki kotoba, which is for writing. These are a little different. And also, tamego, which is casual way of talking, and keigo, which we use when we talk with older people or respective people. So if you want to master all of them, it's going to be hard. And then, listening. Unfortunately, listening is quite difficult too. Same reason as writing, with four different way of structures. And also, we talk quite fast. And then, writing. Most of you already knows, we have a hiragana, katakana, and kanji. So, unfortunately, you need to remember like three types of alphabets. Kanji is a little different from hiragana and katakana. In hiragana and katakana, each letter has each sound. But kanji is different. They don't have a specific sound for one letter, but it has meaning. For example, D, O, D. These alphabets don't have any meaning, but together, it goes be dark, right? Same in hiragana, katakana. I and nu don't have any meaning. But if these two are together, become inu, means dark. But kanji, if we write just one word, this one, it means already dark. But for reading, this kanji can be read many other way too. And also, some people ask like, I don't remember all the kanjis. Don't worry, because we as Japanese don't know all of them. You just need to memorize the one you use often. And as you know, nowadays we just type. So as long as you can read, it's enough. And lastly, grammar. I can just say grammar is opposite from English, so depends on your language. If your language has same structure as English, can be different, so might be difficult. But if structure is same as Japanese, it's very easy for you. So basically, in Japanese, verb come to the end, no matter what. For example, if it's English, I eat apple. But Japanese is gonna be I, apple, eat. Watashi wa ringo o tabemasu. So what do you think? You think Japanese is difficult? I think answer is kind of difficult. But I think this is same as in any other languages. Learning language is quite hard. Another thing I'm often asked is anime useful to learn Japanese? I think it's good to motivate you to study. But don't believe all. For example, no one said Dattebayo or us or like Crayon Shinchan. When we come back home, we don't say Okaeri. We have to say Tadaima. These kind of things happen quite often in anime. So don't believe it all. But still, it's good to motivate you. So for beginner, I think it's good to watch just to pick up some words and get used to Japanese sound. And only for more than intermediate, you can use for listening practice. Because you already know what is for only anime and what is for real life. So lastly, where to start for studying Japanese? I think everyone has own opinion, so this is my opinion. I think first things you need to do is hiragana and some expression like greeting or introduce yourself. Some people try to study with alphabet, but for me it's very strange. Imagine if I study English like this. Thank you. It's not thank you. Thank you. It's still Japanese. I feel same way if you write like this. This is arigato. It's not Japanese. In Japanese, we say arigato. And also, if you already know hiragana chart, it would help you when you start learning conjugation. There are so many videos or apps to study hiragana, but my favorite is this one, Song for Japanese Learner from Mihara Japan on YouTube. Most of hiragana song on YouTube is like for kids, but this is very catchy. My husband found this channel by chance. It was like 3 years ago, but we still remember the song and we can sing in the air. You should check it out. A, I, U, E, O, Ka, Ki, Ku, Ke, Ko, Sa, Si, Su, Se, So. The song is like this. But if you're just learning hiragana, it doesn't make you feeling like studying Japanese or obtaining some language. So I recommend you to learn some expression at the same time. Then you can just say like greeting, konnichiwa or arigato. And then after, you can learn katakana and grammar. I recommend you to learn hiragana first because we use more. But if you know katakana, you already can get so many words because katakana we often use for the language which come from other country, like country name or IT word. So when you know katakana, you can already read so many things and already get the meaning. For example, pork, spoon, noto, ice cream, something like this. See, already you know some words. And then you can find language partners or friends or tutor. Because if you study just at home alone, you cannot feel you are improving or you can speak with someone because you don't speak, right? So after you got the basic grammar and hiragana katakana, now you can start practicing speaking. And kanji, you can study with grammar. Because some people write all over again and again. But for my opinion, you should study with sentence, how you use. When I was a kid, I wrote a lot for each kanji. But I was just like 8 years old. I have so many years to study. We studied like 1,500 kanji in 6 years. So like one kanji for 3 days, we have so much time. But in your case, you want to learn as fast as possible. So better run with how to use. If you need example of how to use kanji, I have a video for you too. So conclusion, first hiragana and easy expression. And secondly, katakana and start learning grammar. And then lastly, find someone to talk with. That's all for today. I hope this solved your wonder. But most important thing is wonder not too long. Start studying. And if you need help, I'm here for you. Let's study together. If you like this video, please give me a like and subscribe and share this video with your friends. また見てねー!